A question I get every fall is, should I fertilize my fruit trees now? And if so, what ratio fertilizer? Again, it's probably not a good idea to fertilize fruit trees this time of year, especially with nitrogen. Nitrogen and fall rains can trigger a new flush of vegetative growth that can leave the plants very susceptible to winter injury. You can fertilize in late winter. I typically like to put nitrogen down after Thanksgiving when it's cooler and the plants aren't prone to growth. But typically, fertilizers are applied in the spring. 15-5-10 is generally the best idea. It's really best if you use a soil analysis or even leaf analysis to determine the specific fertilizer needs, but that's a generality. Another one I get is, as hot and dry as it's been for months, should we water fruit trees or harden them off as we get closer to the first frost date? Well, we like to keep trees well watered. We don't want to push, again, new vegetative growth to get them winter hardy, but we certainly want to have put on enough water to maintain the health and viability of the leaves that are on the trees and vines. Nita Smith planted a Fuji persimmon last fall and it sprouted leaves in the spring. But in summer, the leaves were stunted and the tree looked stunted. They mulched it and watered it daily. Well, the problem I would think is I would guess that the persimmon was planted in very poorly drained site. And if they're watering and it looks like that, most probably they've overwatered it and it drowned. A plant that's suffering too much water and one that's suffering from not enough look exactly alike. My guess is the root system is pretty much compromised, so I'd plant a new tree. And I would put it on a berm and incorporate lots of coarse material to help facilitate internal soil drainage. Things like sand, well-composted organic material in back into the hole, and then make the berm 12 to 15 inches higher than the surrounding area. That'll keep some of the roots in contact with air and water under high rainfall conditions and provide for water and nutrient uptake. Bell County Master Gardener Rowena Fengel had problems with the Grand Dame brown turkey fig. Late hard freezes in winter 2019 killed several limbs, and she got very few figs this year. Then many pale yellow leaves fell covered in sooty mold. She also had scale insects. Well, since we'll go through this again next winter, cut back to healthy growth after the first hard freeze and do not be surprised to see more limbs collapse. Our freeze events really give our plants a beating. Small fruit, yes, this time of year. Our fig varieties that came through the spring are very late putting on figs. Last year it was mid-June when we started our harvest. This year it's late July and August. Yes, sooty mold, there's some sucking insects somewhere in that fig tree. Sharpshooters, aphids, something. And scale, yes, again, we're going to have to wait until next winter and hit them with dormant oil applications. The key to getting oil to work in the winter is mild winter temperatures at the time of application and thorough coverage. Dropping interior leaves, again, the sooty mold is probably partly to blame and shade. I wouldn't be too concerned. Compost, water, and weed control, just a good basic gardening is all that really needs to be done. We'd love to hear from you. Click on Central Texas Gardener to submit your questions, pictures, and videos.